Hey, what's up, you guys? It's me, Zoe, and I'm back with another video. Today, we'll be talking about 5 ways that you can control your anxiety. So let's just hop right into the video. My handles are in the description below or at the outro of the video. If you wanna go follow that on TikTok and Instagram, you know. And yeah, let's just hop right into the video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Let's go. Okay, so number one is support. You need support from your friends, family, significant others, all of those people. They're gonna come in handy when you have anxiety. So with me personally, when I had my anxiety, actually all three that I mentioned, especially my family, was really helpful, you know? Like if you guys don't know, I have anxiety about death. I have death anxiety. And sometimes I think I'm just gonna like die out of nowhere, because like these symptoms are real. Like your heart is beating, you can't breathe. Like of course you're just gonna think that you're dying, but I'm not. So I've gotten better so far. But like I was saying, my support group was helping me. So I would wake up in the middle of the night, like panicking, and I would go tell my family members right away how I was feeling and everything. And they, you know, they helped me through it. Because the one thing that you don't want to do is like isolate yourself or be alone in a time like this, because you need all the help that you can get to get over your anxiety, whether it's social anxiety, anxiety about the future, your phobias. You need help, you need support. So family is, you know, the main thing. Like talk to your mom, your dad, your siblings. They'll help you get through it. Like I and they like encouraged me to tell them, because usually I'm just like, I'll get through it myself. Like this is not the time to be doing that. They're like, let me know if you're feeling anxious and we'll like support you. Like they're like, Zoe, you're not dying. And they let me explain it, and then they reassure me and I feel better, you know? Family is number one, you know? Friends. My friends, you know, teenagers always be going through mental health issues. So my friends, they didn't have anxiety like me, but they had like anxiety and depression. So I can talk to them and they, you know, they know what it's like, not like what it's like exactly, but like they can help me get through it. Like I text them, we're in a group chat. I text them about it whenever I feel like it. One time, one of my friends, she stays up till like, I don't know, let's say 5 in the morning for some reason. Don't ask me, but she does. And one time I was having a little panic, you know, I was having a little anxiety. So I called her and we just like talked until I felt better, and I really appreciated that. And I can tell them anything and I can go outside with them. And you know, if you have a significant other, talk to them, you know, call them up. Like do not isolate yourself. I cannot stress this enough. You are fighting and the people are here to help you. My family said that we're fighting this together. Like you are not alone during your time of anxiety. Talk to them. I'm pretty sure they'll help you out. They'll help you, okay? They'll help you. Number two is meditation. So with anxiety itself, you like stress about the future and what you stress about future things. Excuse me. You're unable to live in the present moment. And with meditation, you are able to do that. So you can start off slow, but what I've been doing is I've been recently meditating every night and I've been trying to do it every day. And I feel so much better. Like I'm not stressing about the future, about like when I'm gonna die or this and that. I'm just enjoying every moment. And it makes you have like a different positive view on life. Like, you're not just all angry and depressed or everything. But make sure you do, like, you can Google them, you can go on YouTube. But what I have, this is not sponsored, but the Calm app, it's so good. My aunt put me on to the Calm app and I love it. I use it whenever I can. But how I got into meditation was when I was having my panic attacks at night. I would go to my parents' room and they would like try to talk to me, and like, yes, their words were comforting, but I was just like at a 8 and there was no bringing me down. So my mom, she would put on a breathing meditation, I don't know, a meditation for anxiety, maybe it was a meditation, and they had me do like deep breathing. Like, deep breathing is so beneficial for you, it's helpful, it's amazing. So I just deep breathe from my nose, you know, come on, one more time, deal with me. Ooh, you know, and I did that like a couple times and my anxiety subsided. Meditation really works, it really helps. And don't only, okay, I feel like you should start doing meditations when you feel your anxiety comes up, but don't only do it just for like when you're feeling anxious. Do it whenever you can, because it will really transform your life and your perspective on life. It's amazing. So yeah, okay, so number 3 is journaling. So basically you have to journal out how you feel, because holding it in is just going to bubble up and boil over eventually. So whatever you're feeling with your anxiety, journal it. Like, just write exactly how you feel, journal it. And like, these are not only just for like anxiety, this will like, I keep saying this, but like the meditation and the support and the journalism, they will like change your life altogether. So me, I didn't feel like buying another journal. I looked around my house, see what I found, and I got a 2017 planner, right? So basically when I was in like middle school, they wanted me to get a planner to write down like all the homework I had. And I already have like a amazing memory, so I didn't use it. So now it's my journal. And y'all don't need to read any of that, but like, oh, but like, I write a lot in here. I write how I feel, whether it's anxious, whether I'm angry, I write it all out. But yeah, do not keep it in, journal it out. I keep this under my pillow, and before I go to sleep, you know, I do my meditation. But if I feel like it, I write about like my day or something or how I'm feeling. But I mainly do it when I wake up. When I wake up, it's nice and early. I give a good stretch, bring out the journal, and I get to writing. Like I said, I guess if you're new to this, just start with when you're feeling anxious. But moving forward, make this like a routine, like journal for real. It's good for your mental health. Number 4, hobbies. You need to stop overthinking, you need to get out of your head, and you need to get out and do some hobbies. Journaling could become your new hobby. I started reading because I'm not gonna hold y'all, social media is just boring. It's just draining. It's so draining. Just looking at everybody and just scrolling through TikTok for hours. Like, I just can't do it anymore. It's not serving me in any type of way. It's not serving me. So I got into reading. Not only reading books, but, you know, reading a bit of Wattpad. You know what I mean? But, yeah. But mainly books. And, you know, I tried drawing a bit and all of that. But you need to find a hobby. If it's drawing, dancing, and you also need to go out with your friends. Like, you need to go driving, out to dinner. You just need to get that momentum back. Like, you want to feel refreshed. Like, you want to feel like you didn't just waste your whole day away. Because if you're just like there doing nothing, you're just gonna start feeling bored and unsatisfied and unhappy. And then here come the thoughts about this and that. You just need hobbies and things to do. So call up that old friend. Call up your significant other. Call up your mom if you have to. Take her to a pottery class. Do something that will, like, stimulate your mind, you know? Like, I know it's COVID time. It's the pandemic. And it's hard to, like, get out and actually do something. But just, like, create something fun. Like, even if it's not a hobby, like, get out and do something. Or do something that will actually serve you. Last but not least, number 5 is logic and common sense, you know? Basically, what I mean by logic and common sense is that, say if you have death anxiety like me, you're a healthy young person. I don't know if you're a boy or a girl. You're a healthy young person. You've been to the doctors. You never had anything that's wrong with you. And then all of a sudden you feel these symptoms and you're like, I'm dying. Before you even think I'm dying, you just say, I know that I'm healthy. I'm young. I'm agile. I'm fit. Anxiety caused you to have these symptoms, but anxiety never killed anybody. So I'm not dying. It's just anxiety. And anxiety will subside. It will subside. And everything will be okay. You need to tell yourself that. Like, you need to think before you just start to panic and have anxiety. You need to think, why am I panicking? It's just anxiety. Like, you're fine. You're fine. And this also works for if you have anxiety about socialization. You can say, okay, if I go to Mark's party and I see Mark there, oh, I'm gonna be so nervous. What if he talks to me and what if I said the wrong thing? Before I get into that, there's two mini steps within step 5. So let's call it 5A and 5B. 5A is positivity, optimism. And 5B is, I don't care. Okay, so 5A, let's use that scenario. You're going to Mark's party and you're like, oh my God, is Mark gonna talk to me? Like, does Mark think I'm cute or something? Will I mess up what I have to say in front of Mark when I get there? Before you go into a whole rant, say, what if Mark's not there? What if I say the right thing? What if I don't mess up in front of Mark? What if I fucking own that shit? You need to start thinking positively. Start thinking optimistic. You just come at yourself with these negative stuff and then you wonder why you have anxiety. Like, you need to change your thinking around. Like, what if I'm not dying? What if just, like, it's going to subside? Like, and even stress about the future. Like, oh, will, I don't even know. Oh, will I get this job? Will I do good on the interview? What if I mess up? What if I forget to do this? What if I get to do that? you just say, I am amazing. I'm gonna get this job. This interview is gonna be a breeze because I studied about the job itself. I am qualified. I'm a little overqualified, you know? I got, like, you gotta hype yourself up, give you a pat on the back. You need to have a different mindset. So that's 5A, positivity, optimism. 5B, you have to tell yourself, you don't care. I don't care, okay? Like, now you're like, oh, hold on, I'm having the positivity. Let me tell you, say with death anxiety. My heart is racing, it's pounding, it's getting hot in here, I'm sweating, I'm shaking, I'm trembling, my feet are going numb. Anxiety will subside. I'm not dying. Like, it's literally just anxiety. I'm not dying. So I don't care. Like, if I'm not dying, I don't care. I don't care. And you just gotta tell yourself that you don't care. Like, it'll subside. I don't care. So that's what death anxiety. And your brain will be like, yeah, I don't care. Like, you gotta trick your brain back, because your brain is like, are you okay? Like, you have to trick it back. And socialization. You go to Mark's party. Say if you do say the wrong thing. Is that gonna kill you? Will Mark even remember after 10 shots? I don't care. You said the wrong thing to the waiter. She was like, enjoy your food. You're like, you too. You wanna be like, oh, why did I say that? Be like, I don't care. The waiter knows I was just trying to be polite. It's all right. You gotta use that. With the job, with the stress about the future, the job interview. I don't get this job. I don't care. There's many other job opportunities for me out there. This isn't gonna kill me. This isn't gonna be the worst, the end of the world. I don't care. And you need to say that so your anxiety doesn't get the best of you. You need to do that. So that's all we have for today. I've used all five of these tricks, and I've been doing pretty good with my death anxiety journey. If you have any questions, you know my handles, or comment down below, excuse me, and I'll answer them. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and share, please. Thank you. Bye. Yeah.